going to be continuing talking about the paranormal occurrences in Nyara because I'm here. I'm stuck here. So today, two very well-known spots. So I'm going to stick to the well-known spots and cover those first, just because it's a lot easier. Everyone knows these places. They're local landmarks. So, and then I'll delve into, you know, like properties and shit like that you're not allowed to go to. But number one, Nyara Courthouse. So, and there's some truth to this. So back in 1932, a register of the Court of Petty Sessions actually died in a room on the eastern side of the building. His name was Les. So I believe it was cardiac arrest or something. Something to do with his heart. So he actually passed away in the building. And there are numerous reports of him still being there, being a fussy pants, I will say. So, first witness account was by a male in his 60s who was actually doing some work at the courthouse at the time. He reported that in the hallway, which actually leads to courtroom number one, which is at the front of the building, that's the original courthouse of that building, reported that a figure of a man actually passed him. And he knew at the time that this man was not dense. It's an apparition, but it was a very clear apparition. So, Les, fine, daddy. Number two was a female in her 40s who was picking up paperwork. And she was going into the office in the courthouse, which is where you go to get paperwork. And it was 4 o'clock in the afternoon. So, you know, the courthouse closes not long after. So it was quite empty. You know, most people had left. Everyone was preparing, you know, to shut the doors and all of that. And she said that there was actually no one else sitting in the chairs outside the office. And she noticed a man just in the corner of her eye, like in the peripheral of her eye. And he was actually coming down the ramp that actually comes from that same hallway, which leads to the first courtroom at the front. So next was a female in her 60s who was working in the courthouse, reports seeing a man walking down the hallway, described it in the same way. You know, wasn't dense, it was just apparition, and it was there and then it wasn't there. So it was over, you know, before it began. And the last one was a male in his 30s who was actually attending court. And he was in the toilets at the time, and he was actually in the cubicle with the door shut. And he saw men's leather shoes outside the door, like down the bottom. And he very quickly opened the door, thinking that he was going to have to knock this perv out. And there was no one there. And I must point out that there was no sound of a door opening or closing either. So that person, you know, the shoes, yes, not a living person. So that is the story of the Nyara Courthouse. Someone did pass away there and never really left. So moving on, this is not a spiritual encounter. This is a possible UFO. Possible. So it was Campbellwarra Mountain, Kalangadi Mountain. And it was a male and female witness, 28 and 35 years. So it was 10 p.m. and they were actually sneaking up to the lookout, which closes at about 8 o'clock. There's a big gate they lock. So they parked their car and they actually walked up to the lookout. They were having a romantic pizza date. And while they were sitting there, they actually noticed, you know, you can see the whole of the Shellhaven pretty much from up there, you know, with all the lights, and it looks lovely. So they observed a row of three lights moving erratically but in formation in the sky. So above them, they were up on the mountain, so it was above them. And these lights actually started to approach the mountain. Okay, so the lights were getting closer and closer and closer, and then all of a sudden they completely vanished. So the lights were getting bigger and bigger and bigger, closer, and then all of a sudden they completely vanished. And they very quickly snuck back down to the car and fucked off. I don't know what I do. Oh, yeah. Me being me, I'd probably be like, I'm here. I'll come. Thanks. Beam me up. So, this next one, this is a really well-known location as well, the Bridge Tavern. So, and I've spoken about the Bridge Tavern before. So, you know, some people have seen things after they've left the Bridge Tavern after drinking. And I don't necessarily rule out, just because someone's drinking, that what they're seeing isn't what they think they're seeing. Okay, so. The first witness, there's three in this. These three male witnesses were actually in the pokey room, okay, and it was quite early. It was 6 p.m. around 6 p.m. at night, and they actually witnessed a man dressed in older type clothes, what a bartender would wear, is how it was described. Actually, walk through the wall, so walk straight through the wall, and this next female actually reports the same thing: walk through the wall, straight through the wall. But she reports that she saw this figure standing behind the bar before walking through the wall. So, looking into the history of the Bridge Tavern, it was reported, this is speculation, that a man died in the hotel in one of the rooms in 1888. There is no death record of a man dying in the Bridge Tavern in 1988. So that, you know, is open for your own interpretation. I think there's a strong possibility, there's probably a strong possibility that if anything, it could be the first owner, Benjamin Thompson, who actually was active behind the bar and owned the bar. That would make more sense, you know, so, you know, whatever. But the Bridge Tavern actually sadly closed recently. So I'm not sure how you're going to go getting in there and sussing it out, but anyways. That's all. I'll leave it at that, and I'm going to do some dark history in a couple of days.